here with me, announcer Dwayne, and it is time for the last two games of the tournament. And this is where things get real. Not that they weren't real in the last game, though. What a thrilling game between NoCoast and Nashville.
Oh,
huh?
It was a nail-biter. That was an epic for the ages.
I fully expect to have another one right now. The winner of this game goes to the tournament, goes to Grits and Glory, the first weekend of November in Atlanta, Georgia, the 2012 WFTDA Championships. If Kansas City wins this, they go, as they have every year except for 2008.
Yeah.
If Tampa wins this, it'll be such a huge upset, and it'll be the first time that they've ever been. Let's go down the lineups real quick. For Tampa, which is the team in pink if you're watching our high-quality feed, number 138 is Lily the Kid, Reese's Tear You to Pieces. The jammer is number 18, Black Jack, the bombastic defender. Number 21, number 212, Lunch Lady. We've seen her block a lot and jam a bit this weekend. Liquor Posse is number 313, the blocker. Number 365 is Lil Bit Breaker, Taryn Tracks, number 500. Number 50 is Rojo Grande, flirting with disaster, the jammer. And number 613, Taz Maniac, jamming for Tampa, is number 7. Number 78, the blocker, Betty Krueger. Number 80D is Leia Flat. Number 90 is Little A, who jams a lot for him. And Bellatrix, the defender, number DV8 for Tampa. Things just about to get underway. And going out first, Little A for Tampa. And she is the first one through. Lead jammer, Tampa. Meanwhile, correction. She passed a blocker while out of bounds. The blocker was out of bounds herself. So Track Rat, the jammer for Kansas City, is going to get out first. She gets lead jammer. She calls it.
Did she allow any? Two.
She did allow two. Little A able to sneak in there and put a couple of points on the board.
And I'll run through the Kansas City roster real quickly.
Please.
Here. Number 10, Enigma. Number 11, Barbarian. Number 111, Annie Mall. Number 2012, Evolution. Number 24, Bruise Her. Number 26, Bella Fire. Number 314, Hypersmactivity. Number 44, Damsel of Detentions. Number 5, Trauma. Number 69, Track Rat. Number 816, Jade Lightning. Number 84, Tough Noogies. Number 85, Black Ice. And number 913, Jamalama Ding Dong.
Thanks, Joe. And the action back underway has Hypersmactivity jamming for Kansas City. And facing off against Tasmaniac, who now goes to the box on a contract major. Kansas City has a power jam to begin this thing, nearly begin this thing. This is the second jam. Hypersmactivity sails into a pack made up of a four wall.
Look at this solid wall here.
Wow, and this is what we saw so much out of Tampa in this tournament. This is what got them here. They're going to try to play the same defense. It's a no pack. They got to let her go. 5-point pass by Hypersmactivity, and Kansas City takes the lead 5-2. This is the second jam. That four wall made up of Black Jack, Little Bit Breaker, Betty Krueger, and Leia Flat for Tampa. Kansas City losing a lot of blockers, though. They got two in the box, and now they have to queue up another one, Annie Mall, because the first two are already in the box.
Yeah, this defensive strategy from Tampa is really doing a great job of slowing down this power jam.
And now a cut track major on Hypersmactivity, and Tampa will get their jammer back, Tasmaniac. So if this is the kind of game we're going to see, full of penalties, then we got a roller coaster on our hands. Tasmaniac gets back in. There are only two blockers for Kansas City. Damsel of Detention chases her way out of the pack. Got to let her go. That's her initial non-scoring run. Now she can score some points. Kansas City getting their blockers back. Actually, they got their whole defense back. Annie Mall
takes a spill there in turn four, but now she's out of the pack with five in the sky and a grand slam.
And she took a spill over Annie Mall, who was on the floor, so Annie goes to the box on a low block major. Tasmaniac enters for another scoring run. Oh, man, and the defensive penalties just piling up on both sides. Tell you what, man, if this sets the stage for what we're going to see, we're going to see some foul outs.
Yeah, it's off to a very fast pace on the penalties here very early on.
It's going to be a ghost town on this track the entire game.
It could definitely change the dynamic of the way the second half looks, no doubt about it.
Look at this, the third jam, and there
micro-pack.
Yeah, micro-pack already. Two.
And a power jam.
Yeah, and a power jam.
Reese's Terry DePisa is starting this one off in a power jam for Tampa. If you're just joining us, Tampa's in pink, Kansas is in black, Kansas City.
And Hyperspectivity, who started in the box, comes out of the penalty box with a start. Picks up lead jammer. Reese's Terry DePisa is right there with her. They shut it down. It remains 12-9, Kansas City, 26-08 in the tournament thus far. Track Rat has scored the most points for Kansas City in the two games prior to now. 95 points scored by Track Rat. But Hyperspectivity, who you've seen twice now in this game, has put 93, so she's almost right there with her.
Right. That's a great average. Little A has 99 points averaged in two games. That's about just over 5 points a jam.
Or total. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Flirting with Disaster winds up for Tampa now. Enigma for Kansas City. We still have half of the defense in the penalty box for both sides. Enigma looks at the backfield. Tries to get through on the inside. Shut down. Enigma back on her feet. Tries it again. Gets past the final blocker. She is lead jammer and Flirting with Disaster on a cut track major sent to the box. Trauma also sent to the box. Waves goodbye, even though they're both going to the same place, and they run into each other just as they enter the penalty box.
And this penalty party is not going to be enough to stop
Enigma.
Enigma scoots around on the outside of the back straightaway, and that's five more. A grand slam for Enigma. Kansas City looking pretty good in this jam.
Yeah, they got the lead back, 19-12. Enigma going in for another one. She got a three wall in front of her. They're out of play. Got to let her go. Five more points for Enigma and Kansas City. 24-12, Kansas City with twice as many points as Tampa. Enigma going in again. Still a three wall. Only two blockers on the KC side, although they're about to get another one back. Enigma sails through. I shouldn't say sails through. She did have to fight for it. Five more points. That three wall not selling cheap.
She certainly makes it look easy, but here she comes up against a three wall. They're going to try and push her out of bounds, but it's just too much. She's almost out of play. Got to let her go. That's another five in the sky, another grand slam, Kansas City.
Kansas City's power jam is over. Flirting with Disaster back on the track. She goes to make her initial pass through, and Enigma approaches the back of the pack, loses her footing, and calls it. Damage done, 36-12, Kansas City, 23.5 in the first half. Remain. Joe, man, we're going to see a high-scoring game with a lot of penalties if this is the way it's going to be.
Yeah, to be frank, it's been pretty sloppy on the penalties so far.
On both sides, and both teams seem pretty good at capitalizing on sloppiness.
Yeah.
And they also both seem pretty good at supplying sloppiness to the other team.
And here we go. Bella Fire through the pack first. She's the lead jammer, Kansas City. And now both jammers on their scoring run. Little A out of the pack.
Kansas City actually has all four blockers out on the track. Evolution, Trauma, Jade Lightning, and Tough Noogies open up a lane for Bella Fire. And Bella Fire puts one scoring run on the board, makes it 40-12. Yeah. Under 23 minutes. Tampa did get their fourth blocker back, so
we've got a
strange. It looks so weird.
We've got a full team for both sides on the track for the first time since I think the first jam.
BUI of Jacksonville has joined us on Twitter all weekend. Most recently, he gives another shout-out to Team Florida Roller Derby. The Floridian team's doing great in this tournament. Tampa outperforming Tallahassee and Jacksonville, for that matter. Jacksonville almost taking down Nashville yesterday. Jam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, jamming for Kansas City. Threatens the front, but doesn't quite get there. And instead, Tasmaniac picks up lead jammer en route to the backfield.
Tasmaniac with 10 points so far in this bout. On the inside, makes her way through, threads the needle for four more points. And calls off the jam.
makes it 40-16. Kansas City over Tampa, under 22 minutes.
Looks like now that Tampa's got their bearings together, maybe they're going to try and do the four and out strategy and whittle down this lead of Kansas City.
It would be a wise move. Down 24 points. They send out Reese's Terrier to pieces to shoulder off against Track Rat. Reese's Terrier to pieces looking for an opening on the inside. Closed up by the defense of Kansas City. The entire defense of Tampa in the front of the house. Track Rat having a hard time with it. Put on the floor. Goes to the outside. Out the front. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Reese's Terrier to pieces. Hung up, but she makes it out too. Both jammers in scoring position. En route are both of them. Three wall in the front. Track Rat finds an opening on the outside. Circumvents. Shuts it down. Four and out, Casey. 44-16. Under 21 minutes left.
And Flirting with Disaster going to be jamming this one for Tampa up against Hyper Smactivity for the Kansas City Roller Warriors. Score stands Kansas City 44, Tampa 16. We've got about 20 minutes left in the first half.
As it stands right now, Hyper Smactivity is the highest score for Kansas City in the tournament. She was two behind Track Rat prior to the game, but she scored nine so far in this game, and she's looking for another pass. Of course, Enigma's the big winner on that so far on that giant power jam. She's put 27 points on the board. Flirting with Disaster, out first, lead jammer, Tampa Tantrums.
Disaster now with a pretty generous lead here, about to lap the Kansas City jammer. And she does so on the inside of turn one. That's five in the sky and a natural grand slam, Tampa.
That's how it's done. You got to piecemeal this thing back up. Tampa wants to get back in this thing. That's how they got to do it. Hyperspectivity still caught up. You saw at the left side of your screen there. Flirting with Disaster lost her footing between turn three and four for no apparent reason.
Found the trap door.
I guess so. Hyperspectivity finds a trap door in the defense, and now she is eligible to score points, but naturally Flirting with Disaster is not going to let her do it.
So four more.
Makes it through one more time. Calls the jam. 44-25. 19 minutes left in the first half. Little A is who they're going to send out next. She'll face off against Enigma. Three defenders on either team. They each have one in the box. Again, 18:50. Hopefully you're joining us on our high-quality feed. If not, it's never too late.
Tampa came in seated fourth. They will finish no lower than third here.
Well, no lower than fourth.
No lower than fourth, excuse me.
They could maintain their position, but.
Yeah.
Whatever the case, they are proving that their seeding was legitimate. And, of course, Kansas City seated second. They're going to move down in the seeding. The only question is if it's low enough to stay out of the championships for only the second time in their career. Little A trying to make it happen, and she comes out the front of the pack. Lead jammer, Tampa. Tampa Roller Derby. The Flamingos, their spirit animal, seemingly. Kansas City sporting the wolves on their helmets. Bella Fires, who they send out now. Little A made it to the pack, put a... Tried to make it through and put points on the board. Shut down by the Kansas City defense.
Yeah, bumped out of bounds. Decided it was best for a reset here. Now they're going to put Tasmaniac on the line for Tampa. Looks like Kansas City has Bella Fire on the jammer line. 44 stands the score for Kansas City. 25 for Tampa. 17 minutes left in this first half.
These two teams have met twice before, both times in South Central regional playoff play. The record has been 2-0 Kansas City up to this point. Bella Fire in this jam, trying to make her way through. Both jammers shoulder to shoulder. Tasmaniac right there with her. Bella Fire plays some defense on Tasmaniac.
Oh,
and moves ahead, and Tasmaniac flattened by Evolution, the defender for Kansas City.
Evolution like a Mack truck.
Man, just steamrolled her. And Bella Fire was in the back of the pack, but she took that opportunity to slide right through on the inside. Lead jammer KC. But
Evolution
one lap later.
To the box now.
Yeah.
Along with Trauma.
All
so
right.
Kansas City going to start this one down a couple blockers.
That's not going to make it easy. By the way, Bella Fire not able to capitalize on that lead jammer. She tries to make it in the back of the pack, but little A right there with her. She has to shut it down.
Reese's tear you to pieces. Jamming this one for Tampa.
Great job by the Tampa defense on keeping that last jam from damaging their score any further. Jamalama Ding Dong trying to make her way through a four wall of Tampa. They shut her down. And Reese's tearing you to pieces is going to get there first.
Nice
lead jammer
move.
Tampa. Man. And I tell you what, Bruce Herr was coming in hot. Swing and a miss. Thanks to a speed adjustment at the last second, my Reese's tear you to pieces. And now she gets to reap the benefits on her first scoring run. She has lapped Jamalama Ding Dong, who's still hung up in the pack, and she is very likely to get a five-point pass of the non-power jam variety.
Reese is stuck behind a two-wall here now. She's clear, and that's 5 points, a grand slam. For Reese's Terry to pieces, you know, a lot of times we talk about speed, but Reese's very able to stop quickly. That's so important as well. A lot of times that skill is overlooked in these jammers, and she demonstrated the benefits of that in her first pass, able to pick up three more.
Jamalama Ding Dong had broken the pack. She was right there with her. The defense of Kansas City bumped her to the inside. So eight unanswered by Tampa. It is 44-33, Kansas City over Tampa, and now a timeout called by Kansas City.
Tampa doing a good job here, tightening up the score. 44, Kansas City, Tampa 33.
And when I say Kansas City calls a timeout, what I actually mean
was Tampa?
It's an elaborate code, and I actually mean Tampa was the one who called the timeout.
The T is for Tampa.
As long as they're talking about their strategy, why don't we talk about our sponsors? Rydell Skates, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. But you already knew that. Rydell Skates, visit them online, rydellskates.com.
And on those Rydell Skates, you can put Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Check them out online, adamwheels.com.
Sounds like a winning combination and one that I know we're looking at several examples of right now.
We certainly are.
Hopefully they'll get back to moving around the track shortly. The team timeout comes to an end. Track Rat is who Kansas City's going to send out next. She'll face off against Flirting with Disaster, the very successful breadwinning jammer for Tampa. 3-on-3 defense. Pardon me, Kansas City only has two blockers on the track. And Track Rat!
Oh, Track Rat going to go to the box for, is that a
multiplayer? Block on the jammer. Track Rat sent to the box.
Blackjack going to the box now for Tampa.
Lead jammer, Tampa on a power jam. Kansas City does have a defensive advantage this second. 3-on-2. Flirting with Disaster, holds back, eyes set on the defense.
On the inside.
Yep.
Nice move. 5 more points for Tampa, a grand slam.
Makes a 44-38. If she's not careful, she's going to put Tampa in the lead. On the inside, pushed down by Bruce Herr.
Oh.
Elbow major on Annie Mall sends her to the box. She's going to have to queue up because there's already two Kansas City blockers waiting for her.
She picks up 5 more and calls it off. I'm not sure if I would have called that one off. Maybe she could have tried for another pass there.
Yeah, potentially. I imagine the reasoning was put out another blocker and try, or another jammer, and try to get that lead jammer as soon as possible before the power jam comes to an end on the next one. Tampa now down only 1 point. 44-33, Kansas City over Tampa. Both teams playing for a ticket to Atlanta, November 2nd through 4th.
Little A takes the inside lane, and she is your lead jammer, Tampa.
And it looks like we're going to have a lead change. Little A plunges into the pack. Actually, I should say, sails by the pack untouched until Tough Noogies finds her. Cannot stop her. 5-point pass, and Tampa takes the lead, 48-44.
And again, on the inside, she picks up five more. Another grand slam. Tampa looking pretty good in this jam.
Uh-oh, and Track Rat comes out of the box and immediately gets another cut track major. So another minute of power jam for Tampa.
Oh, wow, this could be.
This is going to be ugly.
This could be the moment that we look back on at the end of the bout and say, hey, you remember that part about 12 minutes left in the first half? This could be it. Another 5 points for Little A.
Man, Little A just sailing around the track. Only two blockers standing her way this time.
Wow, look at that agility.
Trauma gets a piece of her, sends her to the outside and puts it in reverse. She got to recycle herself. Now Trauma blasts into it, knocks her down forward, and she's going to get a back block major for that. And Bruiser gets one also. Both blockers go to the box. There's already two blockers there. The defensive penalties piling up fast for Kansas City. And Tampa's had plenty of their own, but they don't have any right now. And this power jam just will not end.
You know, Dwayne, I can't say that I can remember a time I've seen Kansas City pick up so many penalties.
No, this is
unusual.
They've been known to do it from time to time, but this is one of the biggest penalty meltdowns we've seen. All right, the jam comes to an end. Little A sails in for one more scoring run, knocked to the inside. She puts a couple more points on the board, 85-44.
42 points in that jam.
Jeez. Yeah, 42-point jam. 42. Double power jam.
That is something to behold. Little A. Wow.
Listen to the Tampa fans chanting Little A down there. A 42-point run. 11:09 left before halftime. And for the rest of this game, if Tampa is ahead, it'll be impossible for you not to measure their lead against a 42-point power jam.
Yeah, that is so true. We've got an official timeout here on the track. We'll take this moment to let you know about PrintCo. For your league's printing and promotional needs, hit up PrintCoGraphics.com. We'd also like to thank our WFTDA partners, WFTDA.tv partners, Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, Derbalife, Derby for All, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Skate Shop, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear. Thank you so much to our WFTDA.tv partners.
If you want to talk to us online, go to Twitter and tweet using the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA.
That's talk numeral to WFTDA.
Sashin Victim has just informed us on Talk to WFTDA that 42 points in one jam is the most scored in one jam in the playoffs.
Wow.
Little A did it against Kansas City.
Carving out a little piece of roller derby history for herself there, and you saw it right here on WFTDA.tv. Thank you so much for joining us all weekend long. This has been some incredible derby here from Lincoln, Nebraska.
It's an official timeout, and we're going to see what we can find out about it. Randy Pan points out that it's not only a new record jam, but they almost doubled KC's score. Two more points than they would have.
Wow.
85-44, Tampa over Kansas City. Two jams ago, Kansas City with a, 20-point lead?
Yeah, we certainly wouldn't call it a comfortable lead, but they were on their way there. And it is not the case now, as Tampa leads 85, Kansas City with 44. We've got just over 11 minutes left, and we are about to get back into the action here.
In this game, both teams came out the door just dropping penalties everywhere. Tampa reined them in a little bit, and that was enough to get in front of Kansas City to the tune of 41 points.
Tasmaniac now in the lead as
John Porter kept abreast of that last OTO. Let's find out what it was.
And on the official timeout, Black was contesting the Jammer penalty. Call stands.
There you go. Kansas City saying that that last Jammer penalty, which I guess would have been, I don't know, the second cut track major.
Yeah.
But the call stands. Bella Fire is who Kansas City sends out next. Little A for Tampa. 3-2 defense in favor of Tampa.
Little A trying to find an outside lane and jukes to the inside. She's lead Jammer.
Casey Masterpiece, recently a Kansas City All-Star, recently transferred away from Kansas City, asks on the line for a penalty update, and we'll try to get you one at halftime. Bella Fire makes it out of the pack, but she does not sneak in there. Little A, four and out. 82-44.
If you're just joining us on WFTDA.TV, Tampa is in pink, the Kansas City Roller Warriors in black. And we've got about 9.5 minutes left in this first half and another official timeout. Make sure you check out Iron Doll Clothing, custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009. That's Iron Doll Clothing. Check them out online, irondollclothing.com.
Micro pack when the action resumes. Kansas City having a penalty meltdown, but Tampa not far behind. They have had plenty of blockers in the box during this game and plenty of jammers in the box as well. Kansas City now gets a blocker back. The blockers have been released, but the jammers have not. Jamalama Ding Dong trying to make her way through this abbreviated pack. Flirting with disaster. Pushes the front, gets around, brews her, lead Jammer Tampa. Jamalama Ding Dong stuck behind the three wall in the back of the pack.
Tries to bolt through, but gets denied. And we've got a pile up in turn four.
And it looks like Flirting with Disaster will not get in front of Hyperspectivity. She calls the jam, Jamalama Ding Dong rather, calls the jam after 4 points. And Jamalama en route to the back, but she doesn't get there in time. Four and out, Tampa, 86-44. 8 minutes and 10 seconds left in the first half. Track Rat is going to go out next for Kansas City. And she faces off against Reese's Tear You to Pieces. Only two blockers for Tampa, Kansas City with only three. Reese is looking for a way up the middle, but Track Rat finds one on the inside. Lead Jammer, Kansas City. Reese is still hung up. Kansas City gets her other blocker back, but now Reese finds her way out.
Both Jammers now on their scoring run, but Track Rat has about a 30 to 40 foot head start here. She's making her way to the back of the pack here. Very fast moving pack. I think they're trying to outrun her here. I don't think they're going to have success in that, but there's a whip as she catches up to the three wall now. Jukes to the inside and calls it. I think she picked up two. We'll see what the official word is. Three. She picked up three on that one.
3 points. Yep, she got pushed out to the inside and called off the jam before she get the cut track major.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if she picked up that third one before she left out of bounds, but the referee's got a much better view on it than we do from up here.
Yeah, she definitely, the fourth blocker was definitely ahead of her. So three and out Kansas City, 47 is what they're brought up to now, but Tampa still hanging on 86, under 7 minutes left in the first half. Hyperspectivity jamming for Kansas City, but Tasmaniac for Tampa, and they're going to get their jammer through first. However, on a forearm major, she is ineligible for lead jammer, so Hyperspectivity going to pick it up and shut it down. No points for anybody. It remains 86-47. Tampa over Kansas City, 6.5 minutes left in the first half. Every league needs printed materials to promote themselves. Why not go to Printco Graphics for it? Hit them up online at printcographics.com.
quick clarification, the 42-point jam was a scoring error. It was actually 32 points was scored by Little A on that power jam. So the score, as it stands now, is correct.
All right. So how about that? The 42-point power jam, monster jam by Little A, was scored incorrectly. It was actually only worth 32 points. That was the official timeout that we just had. The score has been adjusted. So, Track Rat goes out next, so it is 86-47. Of course, that's close to what it was after that power jam, and then Tampa has had a couple of four and outs since then, so we're back up close to around the area where they were after that erroneously scored power jam. So sorry about the record-breaking news and everything, but actually she was 10 points away.
Rojo Grande jamming this one for Tampa, but not fast enough as Track Rat makes her way through the pack first on the inside to become the lead jammer. Rojo Grande now jukes to the outside, breaks free of the pack, but Track Rat almost back to the back of the pack here. Quite a lead as she jukes to the inside, gets bumped out of bounds, and she calls it off. She's able to pick up 4 points, though, before she leaves the boundaries, and that's four more to the score of Kansas City. Kansas City now 51, Tampa 86, with about 4.5 minutes left in the first half.
So Little A did not break the record we thought she broke, but still a wonderful performance out of Little A. Mind you, Little A, and I don't know how much we've said this, actually broke her one of her toes. And it doesn't look very nice. She did that earlier in the tournament, continued to skate on it. So,
just keep that in mind every time you see
that. These are the kind of numbers she's putting up. Action back underway. Reese's tearing to pieces, jamming for Tampa, but Trauma, who had been blocking up to this point, jams for Kansas City, immediately picks up lead jammer. She's back to the pack, slides through, 4 points for Kansas City. Four and out. Kansas City climbing back up. We'll see. 86-55, 3.5 minutes left before halftime. Talk to us online on Twitter by using the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. Chicago Outfit wants to know, where did some of Tampa's points go? So again, Little A had a 42-point just monster jam on two power jams in a row. The Kansas City jammer came back and was immediately sent back again on a cut track minor. 42 points is what she seemed to score, but after a lengthy official timeout, it turned out that there were two extra scoring passes recorded. She only scored 32 points, so that's where some of Tampa's points went. 86-55, under 3 minutes left. Kansas City sends out Bella Fire. She immediately picks up lead jammer, but out of the pack comes Little A. And Bella Fire going to get there first. Little A's not too far behind her. The Kansas City blockers are in the back of the pack. And I don't know. I think that...
Yep, picked up some, allowed some.
And allowed more than she picked up. Bella Fire picked up two. Little A gets three, so it's a net gain of one for Tampa.
Little A again with the broken toe. What a trooper. She scored 41 points in this bout so far. And that's after the correction. So... she scored 41 points so far with a broken toe.
Right.
That's just incredible. Little A.
Not bad. Big part of why Tampa has grown so much in the rankings, and they're proving that their seeding was correct coming into the tournament right now. But this time, Hyper Smactivity sent out by Kansas City. The defense holding up Reese's Terry to pieces. The jammer for Tampa thus far. Hyper Smactivity catches up, ready to score points. Push to the inside by Lily the Kid, the defender for Tampa. But she makes it through, and a 5-point grand slam of the variety that includes a jammer lap point that is not a power jam even. And she's going in for a second scoring run. Now Reese's Tear You to Pieces has broken the pack.
And speaking of power jams, the back block major going to send Reese's Tear You to Pieces to the penalty box.
And Hyperspectivity got the memo. She did not call the jam. She's back in it. Five more points go on the board for Hyperspectivity. Two scoring runs so far, 10 unanswered points. Black Jack in the back of the pack puts a hit on her. She regains her bearings, makes it through for a third scoring run. 15 points by Kansas City. And they're only down by 17. Hyperspectivity going in for another one. Three wall in the front. Kansas City hanging back. Forces an OPAC. And Hyperspectivity makes it through for another one. 20 unanswered points by Hyperspectivity. Kansas City back in it. Down 12. And the jam still has 24 seconds left.
And this was precisely the opportunity that the Kansas City Roller Warriors needed. Another five in the sky, a grand slam for Hyperspectivity.
And the power jam is still not ended. And we actually have 16 seconds left on the jam clock. Five more. So 89 to 87, Kansas City only down two. 9 seconds left. Oh, excuse me, 3 seconds left on the jam clock. Enters the pack one more time, bumped out. Jam comes to an end on time, or maybe she called it. It was almost simultaneous. She did not appear to get any points on the final scoring run, so it remains a two-point lead by Tampa going into the half. What a roller coaster of a first half. Mello Joe, how do you like it?
This has been a sight to behold. Just 3 points separate these two teams. Make that 2 points. Never was very good at math, Dwayne. But an incredible first half, really coming back into this.
I should say so. Be sure to talk to us online using Talk2WFTDA, the hashtag. Use the number 2, Cape Town Roller Derby in South Africa, staying up late to watch this game, and it's a good decision because what a game it has been. Both teams came out of the off the line at the beginning of the game scoring mad penalties on both sides.
Yeah, we're going to try and get an updated penalty count for you during the half here, so we want to try and pass on the official totals to you.
There was barely anybody on the track for the longest time. Tampa reins in their penalties a little bit. Kansas City still dropping a lot of them. Track rat goes to the box, leaving Little A on a power jam. Little A runs the board. Track rat comes back. Immediately picks up a cut track major again, goes back to the box. Little A puts more points on the board. It seems to be 42. Turned out to only be 32, but still.
Still an incredible jam by any total.
Yeah, it put Tampa up 40 points, and then Kansas City slowly working their way back, and then a monster jam right at the end to nearly tie it up. Tampa leading 2 at the half. What else can we say other than it's a incredible, exciting game, and you don't want to miss the second half of it.
It would be a detriment, no doubt.
If you look at the timeouts, Tampa has used one of theirs. Kansas City still has all three of theirs. Kansas City trails by 2 points. It has been, they've been up by 20, they've been down by 40.
And there's been no lack of excitement in this bout, let me tell you.
Yeah, that tells you that right there.
If you're just joining us, Tampa's in pink. The Kansas City Roller Warriors in black. And right now, Tampa leads only by 2 points.
Yep, 89-87, and we're about to see a second half that is going to affect a lot of people going into the next month, early November. Little A is who Tampa's going to send out next. Trauma. You know, actually, you think about the results of these games, and not only the skaters. The skaters, the support staff, the fans, so many people's travel plans, what they're going to do over the next season, whether the team's going to stay home. I mean, there is just the teams that they're potentially going to play once they get there, which, by the way, following the second game tonight, the last game tonight, we'll find out where all the seedings go for going into the championship game. So don't go away after the closing ceremonies. Action back underway. Trauma, who was successful in the first half, sent out. Puts 4 points on the board and out. Little A had broken the pack, so she was in scoring position as well. Four and out Kansas City. We have a lead change 30 seconds into the second half.
Wasting no time is Kansas City now putting Track Rat on the jammer line up against Taz Maniac.
Track Rat, Taz Maniac, 3-2 defense.
We're seeing Flirting with Disaster and Betty Krueger as blockers for Tampa, along with Lunch Lady and Lily the Kid. And
Track Rat up the gut untouched. No, correction. Betty Krueger out in front of her. Now she makes it out. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Betty Krueger, the defender for Tampa, had a piece of her, but she wound up letting her go. The lead jammer, Track Rat, en route to the backfield in scoring position, and the Tampa jammer still hung up.
Tasmaniac caught up in a two-wall, now a three-wall, now at the back of the pack. Meanwhile, Track Rat tries to bust through a two-wall at the front, and she does. That's a grand slam, Kansas City.
So four more points for Track Rat, and she is en route to the backfield. A thick Tampa wall in the back. She finds her way smack dab into the middle of them. No way. She gets around them on the outside a little bit. 3 points, three more points for Kansas City. Now they have a 10-point lead. 12 unanswered points by Kansas City in the second half, and that was a third jam.
Reese's tear you to pieces, taking the jammer line for Tampa. She's picked up 8 points so far in this bout, going up against number 26, Bella Fire. She's had 6 points of her own for the Kansas City Roller Warriors.
Three-on-three defense. Action back underway, a term we use in the loosest sense because the defense has been... Oh, Kansas City, just wait until they got one of their blockers back. Then they take an ease in one to the line, and the jammers are released. Bella Fire trying to find an opening on the outside.
Reese is tearing to pieces, just planting that shoulder in the wall, trying to wedge her way through, and she's making a little bit of traction here as she makes her way to the front two-all and out of the pack, but did not do so cleanly. She picked up a minor track cut.
Evolution bumped her to the inside and forced the cut. It was only a minor, but kept her from getting lead jammer. Bella Fire got it herself directly after that. And
Evolution doing a great job protecting that lead right now.
Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. Of course, Bella Fire called it off immediately. No points for anybody. It remains 99-89. Kansas City over Tampa. 26-43 left in the contest. The second to last contest of the game and the one that determines who's going to go to championships and who's not.
Enigma jamming this one for Kansas City, but right now it's all Flirting with Disaster. She's really jammer for Tampa. She's got 23 points so far in this bout.
Enigma is out of the pack as well, so Flirting Disaster is going to get one scoring run maximum. Finds a three-wall in the front of the pack, and Enigma about to sneak in there. Flirting calls it. Oh, but not in time. Enigma puts 3 points on the board. Flirting only gets one. Net gain of two for Kansas City. 102-90. Flirting a little nonplussed as she leaves the track. Little A is who they send out now. Trauma standing on the line for Kansas City. Trauma blocked most of the first half. Maybe it's because of the penalties. Maybe it's because she was successful at putting points on the board, but they're jamming her more often in the second half. Of course, we told you at halftime that she has put 5 penalty minutes on the board. Trauma looking for the front of the pack, taken down, but she gets back on her feet. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Tampa loses a blocker to the box.
We've got a micro pack and both jammers on their score and run, but right now Trauma is back out in front. That's an easy 5 points.
Four. Looks like Little A did get out in time. Trauma knows that her blockers are in the front, and she's letting Little A get as close as possible. No, she trusts her blockers to hold Little A, and that's exactly what they do. She sails through for a 5-point grand slam. She gets a jammer lap point. Kansas City's defense holding Little A.
And that's precisely the type of gamble that you're going to have to take in a bout that is this close.
That's
so
right.
Important sometimes to roll those dice, and it did not come up snake eyes for Kansas City.
Bruiser forces Little A out the front, and Trauma gets another scoring run. 5-point grand slam. And she shuts it down. Little A did get all 4 points on that, but she had to work through 2 scoring runs by Trauma to get it. So big net game by Kansas City, 116-94.
So many of Little A's points this weekend are those 3 and 4 that she slips in on the end of a jam. You cannot give her any bit of breathing room and not expect her to not take advantage of that.
Which is why it was even a bigger gamble for Trauma to let her into the pack again.
Yeah, that's a great point.
Yep. That's her showing faith in the defense.
Tasmaniac jamming this time for Tampa. And we've got hyper-smactivity for Kansas City. Tasmaniac takes a hip whip on the outside of turn 3 and 4, and she's your lead jammer.
Tasmaniac making quick time. That was an unbelievable low block on hyper-smactivity by the defender. Betty Krueger for Tampa, just foot out, and down goes hyper-smactivity. Meanwhile, Tasmaniac, the lead jammer, plunges into the pack, puts 3 points on the board.
Looks like three from my vantage point.
Dragon Lady from Rose City on Talk to WFTDA wants to know who number 500 in pink is.
That's Taryn Trax.
Taryn Trax, the defender for Tampa. She is holding down the fort. She's a big part of the success that Tampa's had in this tournament.
She's been in 15 jams so far.
This time, Reese's Terry to Pieces is who Tampa sends out. She's looking for a way through this three wall in the back of the pack by Kansas City. Bella Fire looking to get around a two wall in the front of the pack by Tampa, and a cut. No, she did not get it. A lead jammer goes to Bella Fire. A cut track minor was given to Reese's Terry to Pieces, but she's broken the front of the pack as well, so it's only going to be one scoring pass for Bella Fire, which she engages now, and she's not going to get much out of it. In fact, she gets nothing out of it. No,
she does.
She did get three. That three wall was in the front of the pack, and it didn't look like she had gotten in front of any of it, but
must have gotten those hips past her as right before she fell back there.
And a ghost point, because they do. Tampa does have a blocker in the box.
The makers of Antic, Gumball, Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. Green Monster doesn't just give you great derby products, they give you confidence. Check them out online, greenmonster.com.
Action back underway, flirting with disaster, jamming for the Tampa Tantrums, as their travel team is called. Track Rat, the veteran Kansas City jammer, is who's on the line, or off the line, I should say now, for Kansas City. Track Rat on the outside, finds an opening. Lead jammer, correction. Flirting with disaster already had it, but she got swallowed back up by the pack. The defense of Kansas City descended on her, and Track Rat made a break for it. But Flirten wasn't going to let her have it. She shuts it down. No points for anybody. Once again, 119 to 97. Kansas City over Tampa, 21-09 left in the contest. Man, Melojo, what a third place game. Third place games are always good. They tend to be in these playoff tournaments. But, man, this one is.
Yeah, because the winner is going to Atlanta. The loser going to have to buy their tickets.
Yeah, neither one is going to make it easy for the other. This time, Kansas City sends in Trauma. Trauma having success as a jammer in the second half. You remember last time, she let the other jammer break the pack and enter. This is not going to be. Oh, damsel in detention. Takes down little A in the back of the pack. They call it a low block major, and damsel in detention goes to the box. Little A breaks the front of the pack. Trauma makes it 1 5-point pass, and she shuts it down. Little A was behind her, but she called it dead anyway. 124-97, Kansas City over Tampa, 2023.
And we've got a team timeout, and we'd like to let you know about Radar Wheels. Tired of slipping through slippery corners? Try the new Radar Villain Wheel. Check them out online, radarwheels.com.
Been a lot of buzz about that product. Everybody's got positive things to say.
Certainly is. Also, you can check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire order at 2in1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code Bonanza during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop, shock the competition. We'd also like to thank our WFTDA South Central Region Playoffs partners, Blood and Thunder Magazine, Bones Bearings, Bont Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Derby for All, Derby Love, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Skate Shop, 5on5mag.com, Printco, Sin City, Sisu Mouth Guards, Vanilla Skates, Viva Las Vegas, and Wicked Skatewear. Thank you so much to our South Central Region playoff partners.
124-97. Kansas City with a 27-point lead. Action back underway. A very light pack. Only one blocker out for Kansas City. The other one, another in queue, waiting for a vacancy in the box. And that is by no means enough to hold back Tasmaniac, who quickly comes out of the front of the pack. Lead jammer, Tampa Tantrums. Bella Fire now has broken the pack also, but Tasmaniac already there in scoring position, knocking on the back door. Evolution is the only blocker she has to get around. Evolution actually puts her on the floor, but she passes her up, gets three ghost points, four and out. Tampa
picks up those four on the floor. Evolution doing a great job as a blocker today for the Kansas City Roller Warriors. She's like a missile in the curves. You know, she'll just bolt from the inside to the outside and just cream a jammer coming through.
There's no doubt about it. And they know how intimidating she is. You know, and there's a lot of intangible.
Yeah, that height advantage. I mean, when somebody is just staring down at you like that. It's got to be intimidating when you're out there.
Especially after you've seen a few of your teammates get flattened by her.
And right now, flirting with disaster is your lead jammer for Tampa.
Comes out the front of the pack. Lead jammer, flirting with disaster. Enigma jamming for Kansas City. She'll break the pack also. So it's going to be probably a four and out at most for flirting with disaster. But that's what Tampa's been putting on the board, and they've slowly been working their way back up.
Yeah, they're using that nickel and dime strategy. You know, it's a strategy we've seen Philly use effectively so many times over the years, and it just works. It's textbook derby. Pick up those 4 points, four and out, call it off, just whittle away at that lead, and that's what Tampa's doing right now, sitting at 105, Kansas City, 124, and we've got about 18 minutes left in this bout.
Three defenders on the line for Kansas City, one in the box, two on the track and two in the box for Tampa for the next play. Little A shouldering off against Track Rat.
Track Rat.
Track Rat threatening the two wall in the front of the pack by Tampa. Out, and she is lead jammer Kansas City. Little A right there with her. Track Rat gonna have a decision to make as Little A is gaining ground quickly. Oh. And Track Rat with an apex jump. Calling it off in midair, puts 4 points on the board, but Little A sneaks in to match them. Four and four.
Allows four there, but you got to love the apex jump. It's the slam dunk of our sport, and I love it every time I see it.
That's exactly right. You said that last night, and it is true.
It's still
that's
true today.
Yep, that's right.
That is a thing of beauty. Even when it allows four, you got to love it.
Yeah, that is a prescient statement.
And
trauma on the line, but Tasmaniac up the gut untouched. Lead jammer Tampa. Immediately. Trauma now breaks the pack as well for Kansas City. The team in black, Tampa in their signature pink. And Tasmaniac plunges into the pack in scoring position. Take it down in the front of the pack.
Picks up three before she calls it. Tampa now at 112, Kansas City 128, 16 minutes to go, just under 17 minutes.
Damsel at detention was the defender from Kansas City who put her on the floor and made it only 3 points instead of four.
Hyper Smactivity going to be jamming this one for the Kansas City Roller Warriors. And flirting with disaster for Tampa. Flirting with disaster with 28 points so far of her own today. Hyper Smactivity with 39.
Cut track on the pivot from Tampa. That's number 212, Lunch Lady. And remember, Lunch Lady had 5 points.
And we got a major track cut for flirting with disaster. And she's going to the box. That's going to put Kansas City in a power jam.
Oh, big opportunity for Kansas City here. And by the way, Lunch Lady, that was her sixth penalty minute at least, if not her seventh. We'll see what shakes down from that. Flirting with disaster also getting up there. Meanwhile, Hyper Smactivity wanting to clock in on this power jam. Only it's 3-on-3 defense. Kansas City trying to maximize these points. Correction, all four on Kansas City. They put up a It's not a conga line. They're side to side, stretching out the landmass of this pack. So the front blocker will be out of play. Hypersmactivity gets around her again. Another five-point grand slam. Kansas City going to blow this thing open. And another grand slam by Hypersmactivity with the aid of Kansas City's passive offense, or, as we're going to call it, patient offense. Another one by Hypersmactivity. And now Tampa gets their blocker back, so the power jam is over, but five more points.
Patience is a virtue, and it's paying big dividends right now for Kansas City.
Hypersmactivity, still the lead jammer. Now she's got a lot more company than she did 30 seconds ago. She puts one more scoring burst up. It is worth 3 points. And Hypersmactivity on the power jam blows it open. 161 to 112, Kansas City. Kansas City, eager to maximize their points on a power jam. For those of you who would like them to speed up the pack and only score 20 points, it's not on the menu today.
Kansas City's going to do what it takes, and they're jamming number 26, Bella Fire. She's had 9 points so far today. Tampa's jamming Tasmaniac with 27 points of her own.
That's right. Tasmaniac has now broken the front of the pack. She did pick up a cut track. No, an elbow. Excuse me. I'm sorry. The jam ref's back was this direction. It is a forearm minor as she came out the front of the pack. Meanwhile, Bella Fire, the lead jammer, plunges into the pack and puts a four-point pass on the board. And I think, yes, he did. Tasmaniac snuck in there, too. 4-4.
Tasmaniac, that is her trademark move there, is to slip those four extra points in the end. Gotta love the tenacity of little A. She does not give up. She does not slow down. And that's precisely what you need out of your jammer.
Well, that's what we've seen out of this entire Tampa team. And that's why they have been so effective in this tournament. Right now, they are down by just short of 50 points with 12 and a half minutes left.
Little A going to make another run at it this time for Tampa.
Forearm major.
Oh, and
on Little A.
Little A, she's not going to be able to pick up any points from the box.
What did we see two jams ago? Are we going to see it again? Let's find out. Now, Kansas City only, Kansas City gets all their blockers back. It's 3-on-3 defense, although they did have one queued up. Evolution goes for the box now. 3-on-3 defense. Track Rat going to try to maximize these points. You got to squeeze every bit of juice out of these power jams that you possibly can while the getting's good, and that's what Kansas City has effectively done in the second half.
Bellatrix and Taryn Trax slowed her down a little bit there, but just such a spread out pack, they're going to have to let her go again.
And the feast begins. 5 points and another 5 points by Track Rat on an out of play call.
Lunch Lady back in the box. She's in foul trouble.
Once again, 5 more points for Kansas City as Track Rat comes out the front of the pack. Tell you what, anybody who doesn't like this patient, passive offense strategy, you know what the antidote is? Not getting jammer penalties, not giving up power jams. That's the antidote to this.
Prevention is worth a pound of cure.
That's right.
And if you can prevent that power jam, you don't have to worry about a situation like this.
It's a fact. And trauma lines up now for Kansas City.
Reese's Tear You to Pieces is going to jam this one for Tampa. If you're just joining us, Tampa's in pink. Kansas City is in black. Kansas City leads right now, 189-116. Just under 11 minutes remain in this bout. This jam is underway.
3-2 defense in favor of Kansas City. Trauma knocked all around off the line, scrambles back to their feet. Reese's Tear You to Pieces. The jammer for Tampa almost had it. put back in the pack by Bruce Herr, the defender for Kansas City. And now Trauma, the lead jammer, en route to the backfield in scoring position. Reese is tearing to pieces, still trying to get past Bruce Herr.
She's going to have to get past the two wall, and she jukes to the outside to do so. Now the two wall moves up front to try and contest her again. And to the inside, it's five in the sky and a grand slam for Trauma, Kansas City.
Barbarian is the other defender that held her back for so long. Now Bruce Herr goes to the box. And so a big opportunity for Reese's Pieces to get back in this. Middle name, Terry Atta.
And that's going to do it for this jam. Kansas City picks up three more on that pass.
9:44 left in the game, 197 to 116, Kansas City over Tampa.
You can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more.
That's right. A lot of people are going to be watching exclusive coverage of the championship tournament here on WFTDA.tv, and you as a sponsor should come along for the ride. Tasmaniac, lead jammer, Tampa Tantrums. The Flamingos trying to strike back, get some momentum going here. 9:02 left. It is not a foregone conclusion, but it's time to make something happen. Bell of Fire, the jammer for Kansas City, hung up. And there you go. Tasmaniac with a five-point pass. They do hemorrhage a blocker to the pack.
And she's going to call it pretty quickly there. That's not a bad strategy when you are behind. The time is one of your biggest enemies, so trying to quickly get this reset and get her fresh skates on the track.
Hyperspectivity jamming this time for Kansas City, facing off against Flirting with Disaster. Bruce Herr, Jade Lightning, and Black Ice going to be blocking for, as well as Tough Noogies. On the Tampa side, the defense consists of Betty Krueger, Leia Flat, Lil Bit Breaker, and Taryn Trax. When both teams have their entire defense on the track, they've been doing a good job, and you're seeing it right now out of Tampa. They hold back Hyperspectivity and allow Flirting with Disaster the opportunity to come out the front of the pack.
Taryn Trax with eyes on the Kansas City jammer. And she puts a nice hit on, bumps her out of bounds.
Just flattened by Tough Noogies. And she is slow getting up. She did put 5 points on the board before she called the jam. Back on her feet.
And Hyperspectivity was sent to the penalty box right at the tail end of that jam.
Very nice show of solidarity from Bruce Herr, the captain of Kansas City, who gives her a pat. Boy, she is coming off the track very slowly. We are speaking of Flirting with Disaster, the jammer from the Tampa Tantrums.
Looks like that might have knocked the wind out of her there. Little A starting this one in a power jam for Tampa. Little A to the inside. She's up against some resistance. One more blocker to pass, and she gets recycled back into the pack now. And she is free and clear on the back straightaway. She's the lead jammer, Tampa.
Bruce Herr going to the box again. Kansas City's defense can score some penalties when they're really at it, as we've seen today, but Bruce Herr typically isn't one of the main offenders, but she's spent some time in the box today. And this is a game that will be won or lost on penalties. If Tampa's going to get back in this thing, that's how it's going to happen. Little A gets through for a five-point scoring run. They only have two blockers on the track. It's a power jam.
Evolution and Black Ice, the Kansas City blockers that remain. Black Ice tries to put the hit on, but jukes through. Five in the sky, and it's a grand slam for Tampa.
10 unanswered points by Tampa. They're still back 60, but it's that number's getting smaller. Squeaks, in multiples of five all the time.
By Evolution there in the front straightaway on the outside to pick up five more. We got both jammers back on the track now.
Yes, sir. The power jam is over. Hyperspectivity out the front, so Little A going to be, this is probably going to be it for her on the jam. And she enters for one more scoring run. She does get all four, shuts it down, but 14 unanswered by Tampa. Now it's 197, 145, under 6 minutes left. Woo, what a physical, crazy game. There are a lot of penalties.
Yeah, Tampa Score sits 145, Kansas 197. We've got about 5.5 minutes left, and we've got a timeout. We'd like to thank Union Vacations providing a trip to the 2013 champs to the winner, providing a trip to the 2013 champs to the winner of the bracket bonanza. Hope you've been playing along at home. You can still get in on the championship bracket. No perfect brackets for this tournament, though, as we've seen a lot of upsets here.
Yeah, nobody could have predicted this. Florida, all three teams from Florida came in strong.
Right, and they were kind of the wild card. We've got a couple new faces to the playoff season, and didn't really know what to expect heading into this. And
the number two seed, Kansas City, fighting just to go to championships, fighting for third. The number two seed in the tournament, Houston, coming in ninth.
Yeah, it was unexpected. Let us know your thoughts about the bout you're seeing, and maybe you'd like to make a prediction about the next bout.
And of course,
to follow this one, talk to us on Twitter, hashtag talk number two WFTDA.com. .com. I don't know.
Well, yeah, I guess there's no .com in the, you can put it there if you want, but
you
make sure
you
put a space so you get it.
You know the hashtag.
And also, when we're talking about tournament surprises, consider the number six seed, Atlanta, who in the game after this, the final game of the tournament, will be fighting to win the tournament.
Atlanta, and the Cinderella story of the tournament.
And Texas looking as lean and mean as ever.
Yeah.
But Atlanta, red hot going into this last one, and Texas underestimates them at their peril.
That's a great point. Atlanta was undefeated in their last six games heading into the playoffs. They've made some adjustments. It's just like something clicked, and then all of a sudden they're on a roll, and they carried that momentum with them into the playoffs, and we could see a very, very awesome bout.
And ladies and gentlemen, she had five penalty minutes at the half, and now Annie Mall has put the last two in the box. So Annie Mall has left the has ended her tenure in the tournament 5.5 minutes early.
Annie Mall, the blocker for the Kansas City Roller Warriors.
Kansas City still with their three timeouts. We'll see if we need them. Tampa sneaking back in here, 197 to 145, about a 50-point lead.
You know, we've seen some power jams given up with a lot of points, so I would not count Tampa out with 5 minutes left, 5.5 minutes left here.
Bella Fire jamming once again for Kansas City, stuck behind a four wall of Tampa. Tampa is moving kind of slow out there.
Tasmaniac out of the pack first, but she picks up a minor track cut, so she's being waved off as lead jammer, but she's got quite a head start here. If Bella Fire can make it out of the pack, she can call it off and prevent some scoring, but it may be too late for that now. Bella Fire out of the pack. She's lead jammer, but she hasn't called it yet. She just allowed 4 points there.
Well, and at this point, we're under
make it five.
Yeah, and we are under 5 minutes now, so at this point it almost behooves Kansas City to put as many to match them on points and burn up clock time. Bella Fire enters for another scoring run. This time she's got enough of a lead on her that she can get four unanswered, so nine to four is the total on that play. Kansas City now crossing the double century mark, 201 to 150. Jenny Richardson on Twitter tells us she loves to see a team who refuses to give up despite the odds. Go Tampa. And I can't agree with her more. Tampa is playing like this thing is tied.
Yeah, that's been consistent with Tampa, and you see it with those extra points they slip in on the end of a jam. That's a mark of a team that does not quit, that does not slow down. And to the inside, Reese's tearing you to pieces, trying to make her way around Bruiser, just giving her a heck of a time there at the front of the pack. She's a one-man army right now.
And speaking of a heck of a time, Enigma's getting one out of the four wall in the back of the pack from Tampa. Both defenses just coming alive out there. Neither jammer able to make it out the front. Now the Tampa four wall switches to the front, making a three wall as
Lunch Lady and Lily the Kid building a two wall, trying to hold back Enigma.
And both jammers still hung up on the pack. Three revolutions around the track.
These blockers are doing a fantastic job in this jam. Reese's Terry to pieces. I think, yes, she did get the lead, but was bumped out of bounds immediately
by Bruiser. Her. Yep, the captain of Kansas City. And Enigma threatening to get in front of her. Actually did get in front of her. She has to call it dead. No points for anybody. Excellent work by both defenses.
And it looks like we've got
Little A standing on the line against Hyperspectivity.
And I think Bellatrix picked up her fourth minor there at the tail end of that one, so she's going to the box for a minute.
That's going to make it 3-on-3 defense for the next one. Hyperspectivity for Kansas City in black. Little A for Tampa in their signature pink. And Little A out first. Lead jammer, Tampa. They want to get back in this thing. There are 2:20 left on the clock. Two or three more jams. It can certainly happen. We saw a 32-point jam earlier in the game.
Now to the inside, Little A hugging the line. Mm.
Just demolished by Bruise Her, and they call that a forearm major. Bruise Her goes to the box. She's got to be getting up there in penalty minutes. Little A does get the 5-point grand slam, shuts it down. 201-155, Kansas City, under 2 minutes left.
That spill, Little A looked like she jumped out of a moving vehicle. Legs in the air, but still was able to pick up 5 points on it. Nice move.
On Twitter, Axel Rolls points out that the Tampa girls hit like a mamma jamma, and they'd hate to be on the receiving end of that those blocks. I would think that there are a lot of players on offense and defense of Kansas City who would agree with that sentiment right about now. One of them is Track Rat, who's taken her share of damage, but she's back on the track now as jammer for Kansas City, and she does get lead jammer almost immediately. Flirting with Disaster breaks the pack before Track Rat can get there, so she's only going to get one scoring run, and if she's not careful, she's going to get lapped. She does. Track Rat stuck behind the three wall, and I think Flirting with Disaster snuck by her. At this point, Track Rat, all she can do is try to match it. She comes out the front of the pack.
Taryn Trax has given Track Rat a really hard way to go, or was there.
And Flirting with Disaster goes in for her second scoring run and completes it. Track Rat hanging back and directed by her bench to keep going. Track Rat stops, takes inventory, eyes set on the backfield, looks for a way through. Flirting with Disaster right behind her and sails right through.
Oh, and she does take a bit of a hit there, but still on the inside is able to pick up 5 more points, a grand slam for Tampa.
Sneaking back up, but they're not going to call it off. I think Track Rat's wanting to run the clock out instead of letting Tampa use their one remaining timeout. She makes it through for a scoring run, puts 4 more points on the board.
Yep, it's time to see how far they can run up the scoreboard here as we are at the end of this one. Kansas City. Let's wait for the official final, but it's Kansas City definitely.
209 to 168 is what we're looking at now. Ladies and gentlemen, Kansas City is going to championships once again. Kansas City, since championships existed, have only missed it once. That was the classic moment when Duke City took them out of 2008. This year, they looked vulnerable. It looked like possibly they wouldn't go again.
It's been a long time since Kansas City's been in striking distance. And
this time is the first time in the 4-year history of the South Central Region Playoff tournament that they haven't come in first or second, but they come in third, and they're going to Atlanta. But Tampa, what a fight they put up. But in the end, the Wolves win out over the Flamingos, and 209-168 is the final score. Mello Joe, what a game!
That was incredible. On Tampa, we saw Flirting with Disaster get 46 points. Tasmaniac picked up 41, and Little A with 73 points. I believe, yes, Little A was the leading scorer for the entire bout.
73
there.
Points. We thought it was going to be 83 for a minute, but yeah. Still 73. Quite an impressive run And, in fact, let's see if we can find it. It's been a heck of a game. Prior to this, Little A scored 99 points, so a total of 172 points in the tournament by Little A.
Very impressive.
Has put in her work in Lincoln this weekend.
Certainly has.
And, meanwhile, Hyper Smacktivity, who herself put 93 on the board, put 72 on the board today. So that's a total of whatever it adds up to.
And That's what it adds up to.
Similar numbers to Little A. So excellent work by both teams in Kansas City going.
Late here, trackside with Hyper Smacktivity from Kansas City. You are going to Atlanta. So let's take it back a step, though. Let's talk about the end of your regular season. You guys hadn't won a game since the end of June.
Yeah.
You were coming into this tournament as the number two seed.
Yeah.
And what happened?
Well, we believed that we had the core abilities to make it. We had the fortune, you know, the fortunate circumstance to play teams that were stronger than us, and we feel like we learned so much from them, and we really thank them for that. Going out west was the best thing for us, even though it was a loss.
That's awesome. So you guys lost against Atlanta. What did they do right in that game?
Oh my God, they hit so hard, and they have these fantastic, like, spinny hip check things that got me to cut track, even though I was working so hard on not doing that. So they're amazing skaters. They hit really hard. They said they'd been watching KCRW footage from 2011 and studying us. And so we wish them all the best. We're going to be cheering them on for sure.
That's awesome. So you guys are going to be going to Atlanta, the number three seed. Who do you not want to face most?
Oh, I think we're just eager to get out there, and every new experience is one from which we learn. So I don't think there's anybody that we're afraid of. We're going to play our game. We're going to be working damn hard for the next month to make sure that happens.
And so Atlanta is now going to be facing the number one seed, Texecutioners. What do you think the Texecutioners need to know about Atlanta?
Oh, they need to watch that spinny hip check.
Wild
Cherry is on fire. I think Queen Notitha, is that her name? She is also on fire. They are great, excellent defensive walls. It's going to be tough.
All right.
For sure.
All right. Well, we're going to watch this game, and then we're going to see everybody here in Atlanta the first weekend in November, including Hyper Smacktivity. We are going to be back for Texas taking on Atlanta just after this. Do not miss a hit.
Thank you. Thank you so much.